Put those headsets back on. Hybens.
Or hang them up in the
up
air.
Against Fulton. So they go up and first ruck contest. Goes down towards Hoey. Gives it back to Matt Tyquin. Kick around the corner to half four. Jarks in front. Good mark.
Good pair of hands.
Gus. Yeah, he's got a good pair of hands for a...
Oh, yeah, he's a good kid.
Small forward. Goes long towards full forward. Tom goes up off the back of the pack. Walsh is there. And happy to see it through, I think, for a rush behind. They will be. Jack Follett sees it through. Ray Bannockburn, first score of the second term. And they go to 2-3-15. They lead Inverleigh 2-1-13. Hutchinson with the kicking in duties. Goes to the back pocket. It's, a, oh, it's okay, just. I think that's Filet, isn't it?
Yep.
Who nearly made a meal of the mark, but...
Lee Football did that last night. Got the bloody thing.
Goes to half back. Mays can't take the mark. Off hands. Logue got the handball away. It's chopped off though. Bannockburn go back towards Tom. Off his hand. Third in line. Milburn. Great handball over the top. And he gave it away quickly. And is that Peters who runs in and kicks the goal?
Yep, it is.
So Jake Peters kicks his first of the afternoon. And a good start for the Tigers. 3-3-21. They lead Inverleigh 2-1-13. Common Avenue Hotel second quarter scoreboard. Minute and a half played.
Well, again, you may lose awareness. Yeah, you may lose your fitness. You may lose your toughness. You may lose a lot of that stuff when you come down a few leagues after you haven't played for a long time. But you never lose that awareness and knowing where people are. And that wasn't just a freak handball or a fluke handball out of the pack. He knew exactly where he was going and got the goal. And I tell you what, I wouldn't be pushing the panic button if I was Macca, but I'd be doing something about it because I've just got a funny feeling Bannockburn can go bang, bang, bang here and kick and maybe put him out of the game.
So back in the middle of the ground. Umpire about to restart play. Fulton back in there doing the ruck work and he gets the last tap down. Tyquin, he's been really good.
He's been terrific.
Yep, going into the half forward line. But he's not 100% fit. He could be real dangerous, couldn't he? Picked up. Peters again went one way, then the other. Got boot to ball. Went back into the forward line. Jarks coming across the front. Can't take the mark out the back. Tom taps it back towards Harding. Can't get a favourable bounce. Parrott takes him off the ball. Picked up there by Filet. Got boot to ball. It's only going to go as far as Luke Gavin. He wants to keep it in the field of play. Does so. Went one way. Went back inside. And Jake Peters has taken the mark right on 50. Now he can kick the distance here without any doubt at all. So they're all telling to do the same thing. Jake Peters. Kick the last and can kick the second in the second quarter.
I'll say it again. I think the alarm bells are starting to ring here. And I disagree with that too about Tyquin.
What?
Well, look at Gordon Greenidge. He made more hundreds injured than he did fit.
It's a bit different when you can smash a ball from where we stand, mate. So Jake Peters steps in now. Long kick towards goal. He's got distance.
Yes, he has.
He's got distance and he's got accuracy. He's got his second. Jakey Peters, two goals in 3 minutes of the second quarter. Bannockburn now to 4-3. They lead Inverleigh on 2-1. And we have travelled, as I said, 3 minutes. Second quarter, Commonfield Hotel scoreboard.
Well, they put their arms up and said they wanted to push down there, but I think you're supposed to put your arms up when the ball goes through because it must have only just got over. I thought they might have got a touch on that. And things are just starting to go right for the Tigers. Come on, are you going to put any input in today or not?
Calm down. Stick to your cupcakes there, son.
What? What? He's an idiot.
They're called wagon wheels.
Wagon wheels.
Have a look at me. I've got him there. These two here.
Hybens. No, band of brothers. Goes back towards me and now comes off the wing. Handball. Sets a task. Mick Gross gets the kick out of the middle towards half forward. Carson to run out onto it. Burke's across there as well for Inverleigh. Drew, handball to Carson, runs through half forward, kick around the corner into the pocket's good. Gerard takes the mark. Rusty's got it, 50, back in, oh, good kick.
That's
good
a great kick.
Found Hutchinson by himself in the corridor and took the mark, 40 out directly in front. So the Hawks need this goal.
Oh.
So Blake Hutchinson, northern end of the ground, 40 out directly in front. Just to make the margin up, 8 points again. Comes in. Left foot kick, he's left it out though. He's hung it out.
Jeez.
And out for one behind. So they go to 2-2-14 in Inverleigh. They trail Bannockburn 4-3-27. Common Affair Hotel second quarter scoreboard, 5 minutes played.
So Tommy passes now, kicking back in. For Bannockburn side, he goes to the far side of the ground. And ball just outside 50, back of the contest. Tyke went over the top of it, trying to work his way out of there. He's going to be pinged here. I think he is. Watching him. Yeah. Yes, he is. And a free kick will go to D. Muir. So he'll be able to turn the ball back inside for Inverlee. Bannockburn with some numbers back now. They're pushing everyone down the ground. There's not a player beyond centre now. So I think we see this a fair bit. This might be the Milburn influence, I think. Ball at the back. Good spoil. Peters comes up, takes the ball, handles back outside, found Watts. So Brad Watts, a little short chip up over the top. Mark is taken out there by Milburn. Milburn now, ball on the half-back line. Luke Bowden short. He goes shorter again. Goes back to Jake Peters. Went back to Milburn by hand. It's away one way. Handball's back. Goes to Bowden. His ball was smothered. Brad Watts comes in, lends support. Inverlee now with an opportunity. They turn the ball over, so they've got a chance now. Half forward line. Good handball up. Goes to Mays. Put his little dip on the shoulder. Nathan Mays wins the free kick. So he's just inside forward 50.
Not the first free kick he's got on that end this final series, of course. Yeah, that news with Timmy Barton over the last 48 hours.
He got a reprimand, didn't he?
Yep.
So Nathan Mays not too sure what he wants to do with this ball, so he decides to go short. Lead up player, Grundle over the top. Hutchison comes up and takes the mark. Careful. Now he calls play on.
No, not allowed to.
He did. He called play on.
Oh, he did. He didn't. Then he changed his mind. I'm glad he did.
So Blakey Hutchison gets his first, makes up for that last error. And the 3-2 now to win the lead. Bannockburn on 4-3. And we have gone 6.5 minutes for second quarter. Common Fiend Hotel scoreboard.
Well, he played on because I think purely and simply because of the fact that he actually missed that last set shot. He thought, I'll just give myself a go at a not set shot. But that asked the question, how can a bloke to kick position beautifully miss the goals like that? You're allowed to get one player to nick off and go out and stand out the back and say, here, kick it to me, because he'd kick it straight to him.
That's 20 goals for the reigning Inverlee best and fairest this year, Hutchison.
Just pressure, perceived pressure, isn't it?
Back in the middle. Down to Tyquin, winning in the middle again. Oh, good tackle, Mick Groz. Ball spills free. Handball comes to Meehan. Handball to Hybens. Four to the centre circle. Right foot kick towards the leader. Grundle has to sit and wait. Punched away at the back. Coming out towards Bowden. And also Jake Peters getting back there. Shuffles the handball back quickly. Well, they thought about switching the play. Bannockburn. They give the handball over the top to Barth. Runs around at half back. Now Peters just with a chaos kick to centre wing. But it sits for De Blasio. Handball to Dan Grozdanovsky. Oh, his handball's chopped off. De Blasio has to go back and help him out. Does so. Then he measures the pass towards Muir. Has to run onto it. Does it sit for him? Dean goes with a kick under pressure. Drew coming at it. Jervis the other way. Hybens. Oh, Jarks. He met it and put the tackle on. Did nicely and wrapped him up. And they're the 50-50 balls that Bannockburn are coming in and putting the pressure on.
Yeah, but the alarm bells have just quietened a little bit, I think, the way the game's gone. It's just gone back Inverlee's way.
So ball up right in the middle. Fulton and Hybens from the same side. Fulton gets it down. Hybens over the top of it. Oh, he dragged it in. Then he'll have to get rid of it. He's still on hands and knees. Howie over the top as well. Pack develops around them and the umpire will come in and ball it up.
The other thing too is, Jace, you said that all players were up the one end of the ground. Bannockburn got the ball. They had to muck around with it because they had no one here. Yeah. And while they were mucking around with it, they got nabbed.
So now Fulton gets it down. Back of the pack, Guido Banks through the middle. Kick along the ground. Meehan's in there also. Banks again. Meehan's short little hand in there. Howie got the kick out. Burke coming at it. Has to put the tackle on. Arclay gets the handball away or the throw away in the end. Stevenson. He wheels around, right foot kick high. Tom and Walsh fighting hard for it over the back. Here's Jarks to run onto it. Sits nicely for him. He walks into goal and kicks it. And he kicks his second of the afternoon. And the fifth for Bannockburn. They go to 5-3-33. They lead Inverlee 3-2-20. Common Fiend Hotel, second quarter scoreboard, 9 minutes played.
And I know you blokes and all our viewers will be thinking, don't tell me bloody Grubby's right again, but I could be. Because this kid is playing good footy. Actually, I did that on that first game. He had something in that first game.
Well, and he just hangs around Tom too.
Well, that's what it's all about.
Yeah, he comes off off the pack.
I know they didn't work too well in the first game.
He done his knee come off, and I thought they were.
They had a few words with each other
It's still a great story. He's come from a North Shore side, and then a very weak side in the Bendigo League before that. Before this year, out of his last 42 games, two of them were wins. Now he's in his first final.
So ball back in the middle of the ground, picked up. Howie again gets boot to ball, goes into the square. Good ball from Grozdanovsky from behind, picked up. Tyquin has it. Strength gets him on his feet. He kicks the ball into the half forward line. Bounce not favourable there. Jack Follett had it. Jarks taken out of his hand. BJ Harding runs onto it. Runs to 25 and goes bang.
The alarm bells are back.
Make up your mind.
6-3, Bannockburn. 3-2 to Inverleigh. 10 minutes gone. Second quarter, Conofino Hotel. Second quarter scoreboard.
Well, it's just one of those games. When they kicked them a couple, I thought, hello, they're going away. Inverleigh lifted. But Bannockburn again lifted again. When you get sides that are so close together, it's just who plays the better on the day. And I thought after the first quarter, Bannockburn won that first quarter. Even though it was only a point of difference on the score, but I thought they won it convincingly. And they're starting to win this one too.
Half time at Simmons Stadium. Geelong 11-6-72, lead Melbourne 3-2-20 by 52. And 10-minute mark of the second term at the MCG.
Ooh.
Essendon 5-9-39, lead Carlton 2-7-19.
Darcy Parrish probably on 20 disposal right now, the Winchelsea product.
Let's have a look.
Or probably on 2, or where are we at?
I don't know.
Is he playing?
What are we playing? Oh, no, he's got 6.
6.
Where's the footy gone?
What about Pops Kelly?
Pops Kelly, well, he waxes lyrical down there, doesn't he?
What about Mark
he's
Murphy?
He's 13.
Where's Mark Murphy? Mark
he's on
Murphy.
Open mic.
He hasn't played for about 10 weeks. What's wrong with him?
They're saving him for next year.
Are they? What for?
Priority
trade.
Cripps is on 9.
What are we waiting? There we go.
Back in the middle of the ground. Oh,
that's
ball.
A free.
Yeah, should have been to Hutchison. They picked it up. It was late, but he's got the free kick now. So Hutchison from the middle of the ground. Short into the half-forward line. McGroz comes up. Good sport from behind there. Tommy Barth comes to the front of the pack. Armstrong had it. Put it down. McGroz picked it up. He's tackled. Tommy Barth again doing the tackling work. So it gins up the hands of Banks. Kicks the ball back in the middle of the ground. Good sport from Filett. Runs free. Armstrong clean. Packs it down. Unfortunately, the handball wasn't good. Ends up in the hands of Hybens. He delivers the ball out wide. That was,
Luck.
I think, Luck, yeah, that's what it was. Dan Groz goes long to the goal square. Ball runs, gets a favourable bounce. Link Peters arrives. He picks the ball up, gets the handball back over the top towards Barth. The ball didn't go to him directly, but he's now got the ball underneath him. Link Peters picked it up and put a boot to ball. The ball went out of bounds and on the full. Free kick to Inverleigh and to Blake Hutchison. So Hutchison now from the half-forward line. It's going to go back to Robbie Logue this time instead. So Robbie Logue from the old scoreboard.
Which is over there now. So Fano tells us.
That's a new scoreboard.
No, it's an old scoreboard. Well, it's the same scoreboard, he reckons.
Well, I'm just, yeah, well, a position of it. Anyway, goes into the goal square and it's been pushed through for a minor score. And Inverleigh now to 3-3. They trail Bannockburn on 6-3 and we've gone 13 minutes, second quarter.
So kick in to the outer side.
Oh, that's interference.
Over the head of the pack, goes back towards Dean Muir, breaks the Banks tackle, kick with the outside of the right foot, Logue goes back, couldn't take the mark, tapped on by Mick Groz to Grundle, through traffic, dropped the footy, umpire said play on, Mays is there, runs in, kicks a goal.
A goal.
So Nathan Mays gets a scrambled goal. That was enough for Inverleigh's fourth. They go to 4-3-27. Close the gap again. Bannockburn 6-3-39. Conofino Hotel second quarter scoreboard. 13 and a half minutes played.
Well, I was going to say they won't go away and they keep coming back. But as good a side as both these, none of them are going to go away, are they? They're always going to keep coming back because every side is as good as each other. But I tell you what, they might have got a bit lucky that time. I thought he gave a free kick and they had no intention of, it was a block. And the umpire didn't quite see it. But you need luck in these games.
When you're ready, boys, Hybens taps it down and you're off.
Come on, Dale, what are you doing? Ball goes towards center forward. Oh, Milburn. Good mark. Plays on quickly. Wheels around. Goes to Peters. Going to kick the goal. He's 50 out. And closing. De Blasio goes. Oh, and told him about it too.
Barry Breen point.
And he kicks it through 4-1 behind Jake Peters. So 2-1 his tally. And De Blasio told him all about it too then. 6-4-40 the Tigers. The Hawks 4-3-27. We played 14 and a half. Second term. Gerard to come down and do the kicking in.
Look, I know there's pressure on, there's blokes coming at him, but you have to kick them in finals. They're the ones you really need to kick.
Waiting for the footy to come back.
Some of them thieving netballers have pinched it.
So Gerard. Short little chip in. Finds Cations. Goes to the outer side. Finds Dan Groz from 50. Oh, holds a high kick. Walsh goes up, makes it better than it was, really. Took the mark at half back, so it was a good mark. Goes inboard towards Mays. They're moving now. So they've got to get around the Bannockburn press here. They go with a kick long. See, this is the problem. They turn it over.
No one
bad. Had poor Fulton to run the footy rather than just kick it like that. Fulton was 25 metres in the clear at half back and took the mark.
Yep.
Chips the ball over the top. Just settling the play down. Bannockburn now controlling it. They're on centre wing on the outer side. Kelly long kick towards half forward or
Invalide. Turn it up. You've got to pay that.
They take the mark. Violet takes the mark.
He's pushed him out an hour and a half early.
At the half-back flank. Called to play and he chips the ball over the top. Oh, terrible kick. So there
was that's exactly what it deserved.
So Jervis takes the mark in front. Wants to come back inboard. Looking for Bath. He takes the mark. Right in the middle of St Albans. Kicking towards the southern end. He goes out wide. Looking for Watts. Brad takes the mark just inside the centre square at centre wing. He goes towards half forward. Long lead on Stevenson. Past him. Logue, and happy to see it over the line for a throw-in. Right half forward, Tigers into attack. They lead 6-4-40, Invalide 4-3-27. So a boundary throw-in. Ivins up against Fulton. So over the back, Kelly third man up to the side. Parrott's there as well. Fulton tried to get the handball out. Ivins left it behind. Rusty, oh, it was a drop kick in the end. He goes through again and tries to get it. Then he gets a push in the back. The umpire says play on. Pack develops around him. Right on the point of the centre square at half forward. And there'll be a ball up again. 17 minutes played. Second term. Fulton and Hybens come from the same side for the ruck contest. Both get a hand to it as well. Watts goes back. Gavin gets the kick away towards 50. Tom comes out, can't take the possession. Oh, they dropped the footy, though. Ooh. I think they're in Valet. And that was the tackle that was on Dan Groz. And Jason Tom will take a set shot for goal from 50 out, 45-degree angle.
Look, I know he didn't get rid of it in the right way, but, geez, he didn't have much prior opportunity. He hardly even grabbed the ball before he was collared.
So, Jason Tom comes in. We're going to have a good look at it. He's running away from us.
He'll kick it high, probably. Look at that.
Right foot kick. Holds its line. Has it got the distance?
That's a goal, I think.
Likes
I think
it.
So. Goal umpire says all clear. So Jason Tom puts his first on the board this afternoon. And Bannockburn go to 7-4-46. They lead him believe 4-3-27. Commonwealth Hotel, second quarter scoreboard. 18 minutes played.
Well, I spoke to Gary Robinson before the game. A few of the Bannockburn people are worried that he does kick the ball so high on a windy day. But I just said to him, if he puts it in the right spot, no matter how high he kicks it. That's exactly what he did, as straight as a die and a goal.
Kicked many goals on this ground for Leopold in the Mick Thompson clash against St Albans every year.
So back in the middle of the ground, ball, hands towards Muir. Muir picks the ball up. Got the handball outside, coming through Drew, couldn't take the ball with him. Has support there, but Bannockburn with some numbers now, turning the ball over, and they go back through Kelly. And the ball goes back into their half forward line. Jarks leading in the race for the ball. With him is Burke, and the ball was now tapped over the boundary line. And umpire says that's okay. We're going to have a ball in the half forward line. Bannockburn taking it into the ground.
Nothing. Wouldn't say a word.
So a ball in back on the half forward line. Peters taps the ball down. It was actually Fulton that tapped the ball down. Went to Howie. Howie. Lying on the ground, got boot to ball. Picked up there, going the other way was Parrott. Outside the Hybens, running player Gerard. Little short kick towards centre wing coming up. Maul is knocked over the boundary there by Reek. So I'll have a ball in from the umpire again. Far side of the ground. Hybens and Fulton going at it once again. Fulton takes the ball out of the contest. Has support from Tyquin. Goes back towards Reek. He steps and then goes back to the half-forward line. Burke out in front. Can't take the mark at ground level. Milburn does nicely. Picks up and goes into Cole.
That's
and
a
then
great
Cole
kick.
Comes out and takes the mark.
You'd love to be on the end of that, wouldn't you?
Oh, look, the defender did a magnificent job to get where he was and do what he did, but he still had no chance of stopping that. Out in front, thank you very much.
So Benny Cole hasn't got a goal this afternoon. can kick his first, and Bannockburn's eighth. And he'll be doing it from about 45.
Only 5 goals so far this season from his 16 games.
So Ben Cole steps in, kicks towards goal.
He can make that 6, I reckon.
Yeah, he's done it. That's a pretty nice kick there, Benny Cole. And he's got his first goal of the afternoon, as we said. Bannockburn's eighth now. 8-4, Bannockburn 52, 4-3, 27 to Inverleigh, and we've gone 21 minutes. Second quarter, coming to Fino Hotel scoreboard.
I was just about to say before, though, Sue, if they can hold them to a 13-point deficit at half-time, they've done a great job, but now they can't sit back and just hold. Now they've got to kick a couple themselves to get themselves back in the game. It just wonders. Oh, worry. You grab the ball and they pay a free kick straight away. All those little tiggy touches when you haven't quite got the ball, they let go. You've got to even it up a little bit.
So back to the middle, Hybens and Fulton. Hybens gets it down road by Tyquin, wrapped up straight away, not going anywhere. The umpire will come in and ball it up again. A 25 points of difference here, 21 minute mark. Second term, Hybens gets it down, road by Hoey again. Got the kick away, Kelly picks it up, handballs it outboard. Jervies. Right foot kick long, inside 50. Tom with the sit, comes up. Cole at the front. De Blasio's there as well. Perrett, handball, missed the target. Tom couldn't pick it up. Walsh picked it up for him. He goes with the kick. Dan Groz back to half back. Hamer goes up. Gerard's there as well. Numbers with him below. Rusty turns around. Left foot kick was just hopefully, if anything. Now through the middle, Hutchinson gets it away to Meehan. Steps back inside, now goes the left foot kick towards Adam Muir, has to go up, but standing in front, Parsons takes the mark. So, back end of centre wing, Parsons just drives it long towards half forward. Cole, Grundle in front, good mark, backed himself, took the mark. So he's at half back now, he chips the ball short to Muir. Handballs it. Oh, De Blasio had to sit and wait for it. Now Hamer, they're under pressure. Back to Muir. They get out of trouble. Through the middle. Goes with the right foot kick. Long. And then just holds up, though, in the breeze.
Straight to him.
Yep. And Reek goes short. Milburn takes the mark. Little left foot kick around the corner. Arclay back in board. Kick towards nobody, really. Cole comes in. Was that high? Umpire said no. Puts the tackle on. And the umpire still lets play go until he signals. Now he'll have it. Just four to the center wing for Bannockburn. They lead 8-4, 52. Inverleigh 4-3, 27. Hybens gets it down on the ruck contest. Side of the pack. Handballs. Watts gets it backwards. And they go from center wing inside 50. No mark taken. Walsh at the back. Third in line. Handball. Out further, dangerous.
Oh, he's danger.
Kick backwards towards Peters and Jarks. So Peters, he's got Fulton standing there by himself. Oh, you better kick the goal.
Oh, he's missed it. He had a bloke on his own.
Kieran Fulton was standing there 30 metres in the clear, 10 metres out from goal. But
well, what were Inverleigh doing?
Eight for ballsing it up. 8-5, 53. Inverleigh 4-3, 27. Common Defino tells second quarter scoreboard, 23.5 played.
So Ryan Gerrard going to do the kicking in from the fullback position. A little short kick. Oh,
dangerous. No, that's bad too.
Turned over to Watts. Picked up by Jarks. Went in the right boot. Back to the goal square in front. Tom takes the mark. So Jason Tom with an opportunity to kick goal number 2 for himself this afternoon. And we'll put the 9th goal on the board for Bannockburn. Metres out, almost directly in here in front here, Jason Tom comes in, kicks a goal, umpire says that looks pretty damn good, his second goal of the afternoon and the 9th, 9-5, Bannockburn 53, they lead Inverleigh on 4-3, 27 and 24 minutes gone, second quarter.
I tell you what, just to paint the picture for all our viewers, I can't believe that, it was an absolutely terrible mistake where the Inverleigh boy went backwards. And unbelievably, Bannockburn didn't do anything with it and didn't kick a goal. So you thought, oh, that's good. They're out of trouble. Then he's kicked out straight down his throat. He's made another bad mistake. So you're going to keep giving easy stuff to good sides. They're going to make you pay. And I'll tell you what, they're not far off being gone, even before half-time.
I was just going to say, this is unknown territory. We've seen Bannockburn and Belpost on several occasions this year get back from this point in time. Inverley hasn't been in this position before in season 2016.
Well, I won't say they are gone because I know they'll fight pretty hard to get back, but they're not far away from it.
So back to the middle. Fulton and Hybens. Hybens gets it down to Muir. Tried to shuffle a handball to Gerard, but he got wrapped up himself. Hutchinson handball towards Gerard. Goes towards centre. Ford Carson, third in line. Takes the mark. Got it. 55 out from goal.
He can't kick that. Just have a look around there, Spinny. Parsons. There's no one moving or anything.
It's called play on. Kick to nobody in particular. Mark, man. Came in from the side, Casey Meehan. Made it look better than it was.
Well, that's what he had to do because there was no one moving for him. Just kick it and hope someone gets there, and Casey Meehan did.
So he'll shoot for goal from 25 out directly in front. Just to bridge the gap. Comes in, left foot kick. Squeezed it in, I think
he's got it.
Squeezed it.
Where's the goal umpire going?
Looked a lot easier than what the goal umpire
same here.
Go.
I thought it went right through the middle.
Casey Meehan's first, and in Belize fifth. They go to 5-3-33. They trail Bannockburn 9-5-59. Commonwealth Hotel second quarter scoreboard, 26 minutes played.
Well, that was probably the most crucial goal Casey Meehan's ever going to kick in his life until the next one. Because if he can get down and kick another one, it'll be another one. They need two, at least three, I think.
I think my biggest surprise was about 5 minutes ago, both Grundle and Meehan were on the bench. Wouldn't you always want to have one in your forward line at all times?
Not the way footy's played today, mate. I don't understand it.
So back in the middle of the ground, this time it gets down Fulton, taps it towards Howie, got the handball back towards Tyke. When he got the handball away, coming off a bit of wing, Gavin, little boot to ball. BJ read that nicely, comes up and takes the mark. Goes now looking for Tom, out the back, file it. Went back with courage, had to get the ball at ground level, but Tom's first to arrive. He's going to go back on his right foot, then back on his left, back towards the goal square. Jake Peters has got the sit, and good work there from Mick Groz. Ball pushed through for a minor score. Bannockburn to 9-6-60, and they lead Inverley on 5-3-33. This time, Mick Groz doing the kicking in from the fullback position. He loads up and goes long, outside 50, goes towards his brother, mark not taken out there. Geordie Drew off the contest, made it nicely and took the ball towards centre wing with Carson. Can't take the mark, front and square, Hamer, got boot to ball, so they drill it along to the half forward line. Adam Muir comes up, he does pick the ball up, but then had it knocked out of his hand, goes to Reek, he looks back inside, measures the kick to Howie the same, goes inside the Tyquin, and he takes the mark. In between centre of the ground and centre wing, now decides to go long into the forward line. Tom's the target, 3-on-1, ball comes down. It's actually 4-on-1, Tom would have done pretty well because he got the ball back. He's got to work hard again because Dalton Grundle taps it up, goes to Milburn goes back. Howie looks up, Jake Peters comes up, lucky, out the back. Jack Follett allowed the ball to come through to him. Puts the ball outside, 50, Meehan tries to run onto it. And it's picked up by Harding, a little look inside and goes towards Brad Watts. And he takes it. Oh, I thought he took a couple of steps there.
Yeah, but
there.
He never went over the mark.
Decides to go to the far side of the ground. And Jake Peters, nice kick, comes up and takes the mark.
He must have a disease, does he, Jake Peters?
I'll tell you what, he probably could have kicked three in the last 3 minutes. But when it's in the air, he's a little bit in trouble. But when they hit him on the chest like that, he's all right. He could have taken a couple of marks there.
So Jakey Peters, an opportunity to kick their 10th of the game. Jake Peters now at the 29-minute mark of the quarter. Comes in. A nice kick at goal. Jake Peters, he's got it. He's got his third.
I think he signalled to the Inverleigh bench
and
too.
And the 10th. 10 goals, 6-66 to the Bannockburn side. 5-3-33 to Inverleigh. And we have gone 29 minutes. Second quarter, Commonwealth Hotel. Second quarter scoreboard.
Geez, they look the goods the Tigers, don't they? This is the best I've ever seen them play. And that's the whole thing about football. You play your home and away season, you do your best. Come finals, you've got to find that little bit extra. And Bannockburn have found that little bit extra so far today.
Got to put Braven back in this team too. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what. Whoever that big idiot was that told me that Tyquin's injured's got rocks in his head. Because he is best on the ground.
Back to the middle. Fulton. Tapped on by Howie.
Ticker.
Brad Watts. Goes to the left foot kick outside. Gavin stands up, can't take the mark. Got some help though. Howie just goes in and gets the footy. Gavin around the corner, inside 50 again. Stevenson gets back with the ball to Blasio. Handball chopped off. Stevenson, his handball back to Milburn. Normally constructive, gives it back to Watts. Just a little chip toe poke. Oh, good mark. Stevenson under pressure. And Perrott was bearing down on him. He stood there, stood his ground and took the mark. He'll shoot for goal from on the boundary line, 45 out. So tough kick. De Brees helping him probably the way the flags are running at the moment to bring it back.
If he kicks it a bit wide, it will, yeah.
Yeah, bring it back.
If he kicks it shallow, it won't.
And comes out. He hasn't tried to kick it. Puts it up in the square and the numbers with Invalid. Greens. Follett takes the mark. Short little kick. Gerard in the back pocket. No 15. Umpire says play on. Now Rusty goes long. And
down the ground,
down
is
the
it?
Down the ground. Did he get one high?
So got one late, anyhow.
Free kick. Logue has it at half back for Invalid. Goes to centre wing, but it's all Bannockburn there. Cole can run back and take the mark. Ben Cole. Settle down, says the Bannockburn players. He goes towards half forward again. Off the hands as the siren sounds. And it says that Bannockburn have had a big second term. They're 10-6-66. They lead in belief 5-3-33. They kicked eight goals.